easy for me to remember.
And he was driving a Geo Tracker, and I asked him how it was. He said, lousy, but I bought one, and it's the best vehicle I've ever had. And the license plates say Hypnosis. Anyway, so we go way back.
Yes, and she needed a ride, and she got one. Even on, Rainey got a ride on a rainy night. Mary Elizabeth Rains is the director of Laughing Cherub Unlimited in Wisconsin, and the director of the Academy of Professional Hypnosis Training in Hollywood. It is with great pleasure that I introduce to you all, and please help me welcome, Mary Elizabeth Rains.
Thank you. Hi. Okay, you know, I've got all the gear that all the speakers have had, so get this adjusted. Is everyone hearing well in the back? Okay. I'm very, very, very happy and excited to be here and privileged to be asked back. This is my fourth year presenting at NGH, and I'd like to find out a little bit about you before we begin. How many of you have been in practice, say, for over 10 years? Wow, good. And how many maybe for over 5 years? All right. And how many for over 2 years? All right. And how many of you are fairly new? This is a beautiful balance. Now, I noticed that when I turn my head to the right, my voice gets lost, so if I walk around like this, is this all right? This is going to be a wonderful full 50 minutes on guided imagery. And first I want to start by sharing with you why I use imagery a lot. I use both imagery and direct suggestion in every single session that I do. And I balance it out because I never know. I do have some tests that I will share with you to find out if a person leans toward imagery, but I don't take any chances, so I use a mixture. Why do we like guided imagery? Because guided imagery is the language of the subconscious. If the subconscious wanted to receive information, where would it go? It probably would not go to the bookstore. It would go to the media store, and it would get a DVD. If it could have Sensorama, that they're beginning to get at places like Disneyland, you know? Have any of you been to Disneyland and felt the little creepy crawly things they have, and then they do the fragrances, you know? They're learning about this. That's where the unconscious and the subconscious would go. So, we're speaking powerfully to the unconscious when we use imagery. I am not a visualizer. So I am very aware of the fact that there are certain people out here that cannot see. That does not mean that we don't have excellent and wonderful imaginations and that imagery cannot be equally powerful for us. One thing that I find that many, many hypnotists do, who are otherwise very well seasoned and very experienced, is that they will tell people, see this. Visualize this. It's even called guided visualizations. Now imagine what that does for people like me who don't see. For years I used to think that I was kind of defective in this way until I discovered that of course we use all the senses, and I add a sixth sense, which is the sense of intuiting, just knowing. And that one for me is very strong. So